In the previous class, we have seen the operation of a p-n junction diode in forward bias and reverse bias, and also we have seen the characteristic, that is voltage versus current characteristic of both forward and reverse bias. Today we will see some of the parameters of diode. So the first one we have is the knee voltage. What is the knee voltage of a diode? Yesterday we have seen in the characteristic or the graph that it is the voltage, or it is the small forward voltage applied to a forward bias diode at which the current starts increasing exponentially. So in case of germanium, it is 0.3 volts. At this particular voltage, the current starts increasing. So that is what called the knee voltage for germanium diode. And for silicon diode, it is 0.7 volts. At that particular point, it starts increasing exponentially. So this, you know, they also call this threshold voltage VT, or sometimes cutting voltage. Though there is a small difference between them, but you can, you know, they are approximately the same thing. So cutting voltage or threshold voltage is if you just extend this line through a straight line to the voltage axis, whatever you get is the cutting voltage, right? So still they are almost the same. We can use the words for one another, knee voltage or threshold voltage. Another parameter is the forward voltage drop. So what we observe is when you forward bias a diode, as you increase the voltage, initially the current will be very small. And once the voltage crosses this particular knee voltage or the threshold voltage, which is actually equal to the barrier voltage, you know what this, why this knee voltage is 0.3 or 0.7 is because the barrier voltage of that particular diode is that value. After it crosses that barrier voltage, the current starts increasing, right? So the knee voltage is the value of that is the same as the barrier voltage of that particular p-n junction, right? So when it exceeds, when the voltage exceeds that, the current starts increasing rapidly, exponentially. When you observe this in the voltage axis, you know, the voltage is almost constant, right? It is almost constant. So if you take 0.7 volts as the knee voltage, it is almost 0.7 to 0.75 or maximum 0.8, right? So it is almost constant. The voltage is almost constant. That forward, that voltage drop, you know, that voltage drop that you observe across the diode, if you measure the voltage across the diode, you know, that value of voltage is called the forward voltage drop. That is the voltage drop across the forward biased diode. That value is also approximately equal to 0.7 for silicon and 0.3 for germanium. Because once the current starts increasing, the voltage is almost a vertical line. Okay, it's almost a vertical line with a very small slope. Then next parameter is the maximum forward current. So the forward current increases as you increase the voltage, current increases, and you can operate the diode within a particular value. It should not exceed the maximum value. Okay, so that maximum value of the forward current that the diode can conduct without causing damage, or without causing damage to the device, or without increasing the junction temperature beyond the limit. Okay, that is called the maximum forward current. So all these values, you know, when you purchase a diode, it will come with a data sheet. Okay, just like, you know, when you purchase certain components, you get a manual which has all the details of how you have to operate, in what ranges you have to operate. Similarly, diode is also an electronic device. When you purchase that, it will have a data sheet, or, you know, in the internet, the data sheets of any diode will be available. In that, all these parameters will be specified, right? So when you are going to use the devices or components in any circuit, you should be careful that you have to operate within these ranges only. So the maximum forward current, it is the maximum current that a forward bias diode can conduct without burning up. Okay, when it burns out is if the temperature increases, if the more current flows, then the junction temperature increases beyond its limit value and the diode is said to be burned out. Okay, it burns, literally burns if the current exceeds, right? So that's why we normally use a resistor along with the diode. When you have seen the circuits for forward biased and reverse biased diode, we used a resistor before we connect diode to the battery. In between, we have a resistor. That resistor limits the current that flows across the diode. Next parameter is the reverse saturation current. So we have also seen this in the characteristic, reverse characteristic. Reverse saturation current means whenever the diode is reverse biased, a very small current flows through it, right? it is because of the minority charge carriers, and it is almost constant because there are only limited minority charge carriers, and even though you increase the voltage, that current does not increase. That current, that small amount of constant reverse current flowing through the diode when it is reverse biased, that is called reverse saturation current, and that is mainly because of minority charge carriers. Then you have breakdown voltage or reverse breakdown voltage. So if you increase the voltage, reverse voltage, beyond this breakdown voltage value, the diode breaks down. It is a value of the reverse voltage at which the diode breaks down and reverse current starts increasing drastically or rapidly, right? That when the diode is broken down, it gets damaged. It does not, it, you cannot recover it back. Okay, so that's the reverse breakdown voltage. Another thing we have is peak inverse voltage. Peak inverse voltage, it is the maximum value of reverse voltage that can be applied without causing breakdown. That means if breakdown voltage is say some 5 volts, peak inverse voltage is just less than 5. Just less than 5. If you cross that peak inverse voltage, the diode will break down. Okay. So peak inverse voltage value is just less than the breakdown voltage value. So it is also called PIV rating. That means to that extent, you can take the reverse voltage. If you increase beyond that, the diode will break down. Another parameter is maximum power rating. So, you know, the power, maximum power, power is the product of voltage and current, right? It is the maximum power that the diode can dissipate safely without causing damage to the device. Causing damage to the device means without increasing the junction temperature above its limiting value. So there is a limit for the temperature that can have, right? So if the current increases, then also temperature increases. The power increases. Power will be measured in watts. The maximum power rating, you know, it's measured in watts because power units is watts. So if that increases beyond a particular value, beyond the maximum power rating, then also the junction temperature increases and diode burns out. So it is, so we have, whenever you operate a diode, you have to operate within this particular power rating. Then we have another parameter, or rather two parameters, the static and dynamic resistances. So static resistance, you know, what is resistance? Resistance is opposition, right? Opposition to a flow of charges is called resistance. Since diode is also a conducting device, it conducts in one direction, right? So it has also got resistance, right? So, and what is resistance? It's the ratio of voltage to current. R is equal to V by I. We know V is equal to IR. So R is equal to V by I, right? So when we have static resistance means it is the DC resistance. That means normally when you apply a DC current to the diode, whatever resistance we have, that is static resistance. Or in other terms, if you want to say what a static resistance means, it is the value of resistance at a particular value of voltage and current. Okay, value of resistance calculated at a particular value of voltage and current. So since we have both forward and reverse biasing, there can be static forward resistance and also static reverse resistance. These static resistances or DC resistances, we indicate using capital letter R. Okay, RF stands for static forward resistance. RR stands for static reverse resistance. So, you know, in forward bias, the current is flowing this way. This is, if this is the diode, this is P side, this is N side. P is connected to positive of the battery and N is connected to negative of the battery. Current is flowing this way, IF, and the voltage across the diode is VF. In that case, there is a resistance across the diode. There is a resistance to the flow of this current that is called RF. And that RF is given by VF by IF, because R is V by I. If it's forward resistance, it is forward current divided by forward voltage divided by forward current. Okay. So it is the resistance offered by forward bias PN junction diode and calculated at a particular point on the forward characteristic. So you have the forward characteristic, right? V versus I. Voltage versus current. On that, if you take a particular point, at that particular point, what is the voltage and what is the current? So note that down and calculate that, you will get forward resistance. We will see one example later. And reverse resistance, it is for the reverse bias diode. So here you can see it's a reverse bias. P is connected to negative and is connected to positive, and the current is flowing in the reverse direction, IR, right? Voltage across reverse bias diode is VR. So reverse resistance is reverse voltage divided by reverse current. So it's a resistance offered by reverse biased PN junction diode and calculated at particular point on the reverse characteristics. So we will take one example if you are asked to calculate the forward and reverse resistances offered by a silicon diode, it is given it is silicon diode with the characteristics as shown in the figure. The characteristics are also given. Okay, we are asked to find the forward resistance and the reverse resistance at IF is equal to 100 milliamps and at VR is equal to 50 volts. At IF is equal to 100 milliamps means it is the forward resistance, right? It, in the forward direction, in the forward, when it is forward biased. At VR is equal to 50 volts means it is obviously in the reverse bias. So it is reverse resistance. So we will do it one by one. First, it is given IF is equal to 100 milliamps. If IF is 100 milliamps, this is the IF axis. Okay, this is the IF axis. Where is 100 milliamps? Here. This is the 100 milliamp point. So look at the forward characteristic. This is the forward characteristic. At IF is 100 milliamps, what is the value of voltage? See, at 0.7, it has started increasing. And at 100 milliamps, it is in between 0.7 and 0.8 almost, right? So you can take this as 0.75. At IF is equal to 100 milliamps, from the graph, yeah, we can observe that at IF is equal to 100 milliamps, VF is equal to 0.75 volts. So just use that value. VF is 0.75 volts and IF is 100 milliamps. Then what is the value? What is the value of forward resistance? Someone calculate and tell me. Yeah, from the characteristics, we have seen IF is equal to 100 milliamps and VF is approximately 0.75. So if you have to calculate, you should be given the graph. They should give you the graph or they should give you these values. Only then you can calculate the forward resistance. Someone calculate and tell me what is RF. RF is VF divided by IF. That is 0.75 divided by 100 milli. What value do you get? 7.5. Yes, correct. It is 0.75 volts divided by 100 milliamps. If you calculate that, you will get 7.5 ohms. That is the forward resistance. You can see this is a very small value, right? Forward resistance is very small because diode conducts in forward direction. It offers a little resistance in the forward bias and it does not conduct, ideally, it does not conduct in the reverse bias. So it has to offer a very high resistance in the reverse bias. So we calculate the reverse resistance also and see what is the value. VR is 50 volts. We are asked to find the reverse resistance at VR is 50 volts. At VR is equal to 50 volts. VR is 50 means it is actually minus 50 reverse voltage, right? So minus, it is negative axis anyway. At VR is equal to 50 volts, we should find what is IR first. What is the value of IR? IR is 100 milliamps, right? 100 nanoamps, sorry. It is, the axis is nanoamps in the reverse direction. So at IR, at VR is equal to 50 volts, IR is equal to 100 nanoamps. So just substitute this in the equation for your, in the equation for your for reverse resistance. Yeah, from the characteristic, VR, at VR is 50 volts, IR is equal to 100 nanoamps. So we have the reverse resistance as VR divided by IR. If you substitute 50 divided by 100 nanoamps, what do you get? Someone calculate and tell me what is the value of reverse resistance. Yes, Dham is 500. See, you should take care of these units, okay? And the powers, here it is nano. Nano means it is 10 raised to minus 9. If you are using a scientific calculator, you can directly write that n there, right? 50 divided by 100 nano, if you do that, you will get 500 mega ohms. 500 into 10 raised to 6 or 5 into 10 raised to 8 or 500 into 10 raised to 6. 10 raised to 6 means it is mega. That's why reverse resistance is 500 mega ohms. So just compare the values of forward and reverse resistance. Forward resistance you got 7.5 ohms. Whereas reverse resistance is 500 mega ohms. This is a very high value. That's why the current in the reverse direction is very small, right? So we say that in the reverse direction, diode offers a very high resistance. Whereas in forward direction, diode offers very little resistance. So that's one example for static resistance. Next, we have another parameter called the dynamic resistance. What is dynamic resistance? So static resistance for a particular point, at a particular point you find the value of voltage and current. It does not actually give the complete picture, because those values of voltages and currents are changing, they keep changing, right? So we have to take the resistance for changing values, only then you get the complete picture. Okay, so the dynamic resistance is the resistance offered to the changing levels of forward voltage. So that is indicated by RD. Okay, normally we take forward direction only in this case, because in the reverse direction current is very small, so we take only forward dynamic resistance and indicate it by small r, small letter r. It indicates AC resistance. Dynamic resistance is also called AC resistance because it is taken for the changing values, and D indicates dynamic. Okay, so if this is the graph or the forward characteristic, changing values means you take a particular length of the characteristic, okay, and find what, by what value the voltage has changed, and for the corresponding you find the change in the voltage and the corresponding change in the current. Okay, suppose if you consider the path from this particular point to this point, you know, by what value the voltage has changed. If you drop a perpendicular to the x-axis, you'll get the voltage change, and if you drop a perpendicular to the y-axis to the point, you get the current change. Okay, I mean, from here to here, you know, from here to here is, it is the voltage change. From here to here, it is the, this path. From here to here, it is the current change, and this is the voltage change. So the change in the voltage divided by change in the current, that will give you the dynamic resistance. Okay, change in the voltage divided by change in the current, that will give you the dynamic resistance. And what is the slope of a graph? Slope of a graph is y by x. What is there on y-axis? In the y-axis, we have the current, and x-axis, we have voltage. But what is this? What is the resistance? Resistance is voltage by current. So it is actually the reciprocal of the slope. Okay, it is reciprocal of the slope of the forward characteristic, that beyond the knee. Beyond the knee means for this line, we do not consider this particular thing, only beyond the knee we consider the values. Okay, the dynamic resistance is also called incremental resistance because it is for the changing value, or it is also called AC resistance, whereas static resistance is called DC resistance. So we can also take an example for a dynamic resistance. Apart from this particular equation, that is delta Vf by delta If, in this case you should be given the graph. You should be given the graph to indicate what is the change in the voltage and what is the change in the current. But sometimes you can also find dynamic resistance if only the current is given, if only a fixed value of current is given. For example, this is the equation. It's called rule of thumb equation, means directly you can use it. And RD dash, that is given as 26 millivolts divided by IF. Okay, RD dash is 26 millivolts by IF. This is the equation to find the dynamic resistance in case you do not know the characteristic, in case you do not know delta Vf and delta IF. For any value of IF, you can calculate dynamic resistance by using this equation. For example, if you are asked to find the dynamic resistance at 1 milliamps, or the dynamic resistance for a diode passing a forward current of 1 milliamp. So how can you find? You just take IF is equal to 1 milliamp, substitute it here. Okay, 26 millivolts divided by 1 milliamp. What do you get? 26 millivolts divided by 1 milliamp is 26 ohms. So the dynamic resistance you get as 26 ohms. Okay, just by having a value of IF, we can find the dynamic resistance by using this equation. But suppose you are given a graph or the characteristic. Looking at the graph, you should find what is the change in the voltage and the corresponding change in the current. Substitute that and get the value for dynamic resistance, right? So there is an example here. Determine the dynamic resistance at a forward current of 70 milliamps for the diode characteristics given in the figure. Here they have directly given the value of IF, okay? That is 70 milliamps. You can use that equation, rule of thumb equation, that is RD dash is 26 millivolts by IF, and find the value. And you have also been given with the characteristic. So you can find what is the delta Vf and delta IF. And with that also you can find the value. So what is the delta Vf and delta IF here? See, it is given forward current is 70 milliamps. 70 milliamps is somewhere here. We take equal lengths on both the sides of 70 milliamps, you know, from 40 to 100. Okay, so this is the change in the current, and this is a change in the voltage. Change in the voltage is approximately some, you know, you can take this as 0.025 volts. Okay, change in the voltage is approximately 0.025 volts. If you are measuring properly, it's 0.025 volts. Then change in the current is 100 minus 40, that is 60 milliamps. Okay, change in the current is 60 milliamps, and change in the voltage delta Vf is approximately 0.025 volts. It's a very small value. That's why, you know, we say voltage is almost constant. I mean, yeah, it does not vary much. Then the dynamic resistance is given by RD, that is delta Vf by delta If. Can anyone calculate and tell me? It is 0.025 divided by 60 milli. 0.371, yes, Anas. Yeah, you calculated using the other equation, I think, right? Okay, if you do this, you get 0.416 ohms. If you calculate, has anyone calculated? Okay, you get 0.416 ohms. So if you use the other equation, because IF is already given as 70 milliamps, if you use that 70 milliamps, you get 0.37 ohms. Yeah, this is what Anas got, right? It is 0.371 ohms. Okay, so you can compare these values, 0.416 and 0.371. They are almost nearby, right? So that's why, you know, you can use either of the equations to get the dynamic resistance. There is one more thing of the equation for the diode current. Okay, equation for diode current, that is given by ID, or it's called diode relationship. ID, that is given by IS into e raised to KVD divided by TK minus 1. This is the equation for the diode current when it is in forward bias. Okay, when it is in forward bias, it is given by IS into e raised to KVD divided by TK minus 1. ID is the diode current, IS is the reverse saturation current. IS is reverse saturation current, and K is a constant. We consider it as 11,600 divided by eta. This parameter is called eta, where the value of eta, it is 1 for germanium diode and 2 for silicon diode. Okay, if the current is low below the knee of the curve, and its value is 1 for both germanium and silicon. If for higher level of current beyond the knee, below the knee, the current is low, right? Current is low in a forward bias diode. Below the knee of the graph, the current is low. In that case, if it is a germanium diode, we take eta is 1. If it is a silicon diode, we take eta is 2. But after the knee, for germanium diode, above 0.3 volts, it is crossing the knee. For silicon diode, above 0.7 volts, it is crossing the knee. Then you have to consider eta as 1. Okay. Then TK is the temperature in Kelvin. TK is the temperature in Kelvin, which is equal to TC plus 273. But TC is temperature in Celsius, degree Celsius. Okay. And what is the VD? VD is voltage across diode. Okay. Voltage across the diode. So if you take an example, you'll understand this better. Consider a silicon diode. It has got IS is equal to 10 nanoamps. That is, reverse saturation current is given as 10 nanoamps. Operating at 25 degrees Celsius. The temperature is given as 25 degrees Celsius. You are asked to calculate ID, that is the diode current, for a forward bias of 0.6 volts. Okay, so what are the things given here? You are asked to find ID. So we know that what is the value of ID? It is IS into e raised to KVD divided by TK minus 1. First, right, what are the given things? We have been given with IS as 10 nanoamps, VD as 0.6 volts, TC as 25 degrees Celsius. Because it is given in Celsius, we will write it as TC, temperature in Celsius. Okay. Then we will find the K. To find K, we need eta. What is eta? In this case, we have forward bias of 0.6 volts. A silicon diode at 0.6 volts, is it beyond the knee or below the knee? Is it beyond the knee or below the knee? What is the knee voltage of silicon diode? 0.7 volts. This is less than 0.7, right? For less than 0.7 for silicon diode, you have to take eta as 2. If it is germanium, it was 1. Or if it was above 0.7, even in silicon diode, if it is 1. But since VD is 0.6 here, we will take eta as 2. Okay, we will take eta as 2 and substitute that in k. What is the value of k then? If eta is 2, what is k? 11,600 by eta, that is 11,600 by 2, you get 5,800. That is k. Vd is given. What is tk? Tk is tc plus 273. Tc is 25. It is given 25. 27 plus 273, you get 298 Kelvin, right? That is temperature in Kelvin. So just substitute this and find what is kvd by tk. First find what is kvd by tk to simplify. What is kvd by tk? K is 5,800, Vd is 0.6, Tk is 298. If you substitute, you can calculate and try, you will get 11.68. Okay, you will get 11.68. Now you have to find e raised to 11.68. Okay, you have to substitute this here. E raised to kVd by Tk. kVd by Tk is 11.68. Is is 10 nanoamps. That is 10 into 10 raised to minus 9. So if you substitute, what do you get? 1.17 approximately, right? Okay. What do you get? 10 into e raised to 11.68. If you find using your calculator, it is this value, which is minus 1 into 10 raised to minus 9. I can keep here so that I can write it as nanoamps. So if I find it, you know, if I calculate, finally, I'll approximately get 1.18 milliamps into 10 raised to minus 3. Okay. Is everyone getting the same? Yeah, almost 1.17 or near to 1.179 something you get, right? So you can approximate that to 1.18 milliamps. Okay. With this, I will stop today's class. In next class, we will see equivalent circuits of diode approximation and some other numerical examples.